Hi guys, this is GSNBound.com and I'm here with the Sony Xperia Z5 for an unboxing. As you know, we recently reviewed the Sony Xperia Z5 Premium and this is the mid version from the trio that was announced at IFA 2015. That trio included the Z5 Premium, Z5 Compact and the Xperia Z5 that we have here. Sort of a flagship, but not quite, because the Premium has the upper hand on the screen area. It's available in gold, as you can see here, this version. It's priced at $500 on Amazon, and right now I'm going to have a look inside the box. So we got the usual manual, and then we have the actual accessories, including the charger that in some countries may require this adapter. We then proceed to the USB cable. We got the plugs for the headphones, and this is the pair of headphones that come with the device, looking pretty much like the ones we got the Xperia Z5 Premium. I imagine they're exactly the same. And at the end, all sorts of extra statements, declarations, SAR info and other valuable intel on the device. Okay, putting everything back in. And now let's turn on the Xperia Z5 from Sony that was launched at IFA 2015. It feels quite light in the hand. That's my first impression. And the screen is a 5.2 inch Full HD one. Inside you have the Qualcomm Snapdragon 810 processor, accompanied by 3 GB of RAM, 32 GB of storage, and this one is both a dustproof and a waterproof phone that implemented a fingerprint scanner on the side into the power button right here, which is a trait of the Xperia Z5 family. We also have a microSD card slot with support for up to 200 GB, and for now we're running Android 5.1, but these days the device has been updated to Marshmallow. I seen a friend who has the same phone and that one has been updated, so when we're going to do the review, you're very likely to see the same phone with Marshmallow on board. Okay, the setup has started. Seems to work pretty fast. And we're already done. Data disclaimer, and we should be in the home screen right about now. Let's tweak the brightness a bit. Well, that's more like it. And other things worth mentioning here is the fact that we get a 2900 mAh battery that should provide us with about 2 days of mixed usage, at least according to Sony. And this handset right here, it measures 7.3 millimeters in thickness. It weighs 154 grams, and one of its core points is the fact that we have a 23 megapixel back camera that does 4K video, hybrid autofocus, and it's able to focus in 0.03 seconds. Also, it provides 8x digital zoom. The front camera is a 5 megapixel shooter, and other important stuff, well, we have LTE, we have MHL 3.0, NFC, there's also a fingerprint scanner on the side, DLNA, Wi-Fi and PlayStation 4 remote play. Also, high resolution acoustics are important, and that's what the camera interface is all about. It uses the old school approach, not the one based on swiping just yet. It requires a camera app update, and then we'll get to the swiping new interface. Okay, so that's about it as far as this Sony Xperia Z5 is concerned. We've taken it out of the box here at gsnbound.com. It's priced at $500 on amazon.com, and it follows the Xperia Z5 Premium that we reviewed recently, and we're very curious to see how the smaller brother is behaving in our tests. We'll be back with a full review very soon. Bye bye.